been looking at the covenant-keeping God. The covenant-keeping God. And from different angle, we've been looking at it. If you read with me again from the book of Exodus 23, and we'll read from verse 25. Exodus chapter 23, from verse 25. And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water. And I will take sickness away from the midst of thee, and there shall nothing cast their young, nor be barren in thy land. The numbers of thy days I will fulfill. I will send my fear before thee, and I will destroy all the people to whom thou shalt come, and I will make all thy enemy turn their back unto thee. And I will send hornets before thee, which shall drive out the Hivites and the Canaanites and the Hivites from before thee. Praise the Lord. Tonight, as we come to the place of God's blessing, in continuation of this program, I want to look at the firstborn covenant. And just as we announced in the morning, God lays in our heart as we're just preparing for the morning program to minister to firstborn. But that doesn't mean it is only firstborn that has to be ministered today, but the firstborn covenant is where we are looking. Now, if you go back to Genesis chapter 15 and you look into verse number 18, Genesis chapter 16, chapter 15 rather, verse number 18. God was talking on that day when God made covenant with Abraham. He said, in the same day the Lord made a covenant with Abraham, saying, unto thy seed have I given this land, not I will give, from the river of Egypt unto the great river, the river Euphrates. On the day God caught a covenant with Abraham, he extended the blessing unto his children. Now, what I want to give you is bigger than something that we end up with you. I'm going to give it also to your children. So, which means it is blessing that will outlive you. It's going to be a transgenerational blessing. Because there are different categories of blessing which we may not have time to begin to look into this night. But there are blessings that never stop with a man. A number of people will start an establishment. The establishment will die with them. Once they die, their company die. The establishment die. Everything, you know, build only around them, and they die along with them. Now, in the blessing of Abraham and in the covenant that God made with Abraham, it is the blessing that we outlive a man. So after you have, you know, you have stayed and enjoyed the long life, the man will go, whatever legacy he has left behind will remain behind. So that coming generation will also begin to enjoy them. In this particular portion of the scripture, now God did not mention specifically which of the children. But which means, collectively, all the children of Abraham were supposed to enjoy certain benefit, you know, be part of this great blessing of the Lord, which the Most High God has promised their father Abraham. But all after Exodus chapter 12, all after the Passover sacrifice, there was a new demand and a new sacrifice that was mentioned in that particular place. So in Exodus chapter 13, in verse number 2, Exodus 13, in verse number 2, God was talking when he said, "Sanctify unto me all the firstborn. Whatsoever openeth the womb among the children of Israel, both of man and of beast, it is mine." So God decided to lay claim on all the firstborn. How do we arrive there? All after the Passover. Now God has to sacrifice all the firstborn of Egypt in order to redeem his own children. And so he said, in return, even though all the children belong to me, I want all the firstborn to be consecrated unto me. He has only picked Israel initially as the firstborn nation. But he now decided, even from the nation, I want to pick firstborn of every man, firstborn of everything that they have. And that was even where the first fruit offering comes from. But that is not the direction that I'm going to tonight. But we discovered one thing from the scripture. A number of things seems to be working against a number of firstborn. Now, because God has laid claim over them, there are other forces that also want to lay claim or stop them, prevent them from getting what God has actually demanded for. So which means God has put his interest somewhere and there are certain other forces that want to say we are also interested. But as the Lord live and as his spirit live, tonight, everything that is contending with the interest of God in any of our lives, the fire of the Almighty God will consume in the mighty name of Jesus. So when you get to First Chronicle chapter 5, and you read from verse 1 to 2, you find an interesting revelation there, an interesting story there. It said, "Now the son of Reuben, the firstborn of Israel, for he was the firstborn, but for as much as he defiled his father's bed, his birthright was given unto the sons of Joseph, the son of Israel. And the genealogy is not to be reckoned after birthright. For Judah prevailed above his brethren, and of him came the chief ruler, but the birthright was Joseph." We'll come back one of these days to do some in-depth study on this passage of the scripture. Reuben was identified and acknowledged as the firstborn. And as it were, there's supposed to be a flow of blessing unto him automatically, being the eldest son of the family. But there was a mistake that he made. He missed his step in life and missed his place in life. There are many Christian who have a bright future, who has a great prospect, but somewhere in their journey of life, they stumble. They made a mistake, and the mistake destroyed their chances in life. Listen to me this evening. I have been sent to announce to you that mistake you made that seems to have destroyed your chance or chances in life, that seems to be holding you back and try to tell you there is no more opportunity for you. Tonight, it will be erased. Tonight, it will be erased. That which will give you a new start, the Most High God, do for you tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord who has the power to color errors, we color all your errors and we give you a new opportunity. In the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that has taken what belongs to you and given it to someone else, and in your lifetime you are looking at what's supposed to be yours in the hands of others, tonight there is going to be a reversal. Reuben was the firstborn, but he missed it. But from the day he missed it, it is said in this passage, from that moment, the genealogy is not to be reckoned according to birth rights. So which means, in the right order, when they want to talk about somebody in the family, they say, this is the firstborn, is number one. And when they say number one, it should be number one in every area. It should be number one in every aspect. This should be number two. This should be number three. But from that day, he missed out his position. He lost out his prominent seat in the family. As a matter of fact, as it were, he has no seat. He became a man that has no seat. And do you know the unfortunate thing? It wasn't something that only affected him as a person, but he affected all his generation. The mistake he made was a generational mistake. And so the denial that he experienced is also a generational denial, which means everyone that is born in that family, you know, they are also denying along with him. Their portion has been taken in the land. I speak to you once again tonight. Whatever it is that has taken your right and your privileges and has given it to others while you are still alive, today, the mercy of God find you. And bring back to you in the mighty name of Jesus. The genealogy was not to be reckoned according to birth rights. And so we're told in verse 2, but Judah prevailed. Now in this issue of Reuben, Judah has nothing to do. You know, verse 1 and verse 2 seems to be one disconnect. Judah prevailed. And because he prevailed above his brethren, he became the chief ruler who ruled over the rest of the tribe. Judah was in between, inside the queue. But he prevailed from the middle of the queue to become the head. But that was not all. He now say, but the birthright was Joseph. So as it were, if they want to talk about the children of Israel, the prominent place that belongs to Reuben has been given unto Joseph. Now, if we now go back to look at history, you will find some amazing thing and see some hand that has played some role. Now, even though that man made his own mistake, but there have been something that was working, you know, against him somewhere before that day. When you get to Genesis 37, of all the children that were born by Jacob, he removed one of them called Joseph and gave him a coat of many color. Now, the coat of many colors supposed to belong to Reuben. The coat of many color represents glory and glamour. It represents fortune. Every blessing you can ever think of. So that was given unto Joseph. And when Jacob was given it, he wasn't given it just because there was anything wrong with Reuben, but he gave it because he loved the mother of Joseph, Rachel. I'm sure some of us came from the family where our father has more than one wife. Is anybody who happened to come from such family? Your father has more than one wife. And most of the time, the battle that many people go through for the rest of their life originated from their father's house. As a matter of fact, some of their fathers were the cause of the trouble in their own family. You read about Jacob and Isaac and Rebekah rather, in Genesis chapter 27, as you read from verse 1 to 3. Now, the father loved one, the mother loved the other one. So the house was divided against itself. And so the children began to find how to work against each other. If you read about Father Abraham himself, in Genesis chapter 25, read from verse 1 to 6. Now, all after the death of Sarah, Abraham still married another woman called Keturah, who gave birth to five other children for him. But in verse 6, the Bible tells us, before in the lifetime of Abraham, he decided to give everything that he has unto Isaac, and the rest of them, he gave them a gift. So you take a gift and go away from here. He was their father. He said to all of them, everybody come around, though. In this house, there is only one legitimate son, and it is Isaac. The rest of you have no place. So take a gift, everybody go away. That is the reason why up to today, Israel is still fighting the battle, because the people they are fighting, they are not enemy from afar, but something people from their father's house, and it is an endless battle. Some of us are fighting a battle that is coming from our father's house, caused by our father or by our parents. They cause us the trouble, and everything seems to be out of order. Amen. You discover that at the old age of Joseph himself, he also created his own problem. After he has united with Joseph, Jacob decided to bless the sons of Joseph, as you read from verse 13. The man brought the firstborn to his right, brought the other one to the left. When the man wanted to pray, he crossed his hand. And that one said, "Daddy, you are making a mistake. This is the other." I said, "Don't worry about him. this one should be greater than the other one. This will be greater than this other one. What happened? That in some cases, those who are supposed to be heard find it very difficult. They have to contend and fight and struggle through life. It is because the interest over their life or the interest against their life is contending against the interest over their life. In a broad sense of this subject tonight, each one of us who is a Christian, irrespective of which number you are in your family line, there are certain things that belongs to you that the Almighty God has determined for your life. But you see, there are certain other interests that says you won't get it. But tonight, whether they like it or not, they will let you go. They will allow you to enjoy everything that God has ordained for your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever it is that has been standing on your way, tonight, the power of the Almighty will uproot them in the mighty name of Jesus. And in specific terms, you are a firstborn and you have not been able to sit at the place of the firstborn in the family. Tonight, the hands of the Lord we take you to your prime place. I said the hands of the Lord will take you to your prime place. In the mighty name of Jesus. To all the children in the house, what I hear God say we should do for you is that many struggles and many battles that your parents as to go through, you won't go through them. Because all the forces that has been stopping others, that weaken and slow down the journey of your parent, will not succeed in slowing down your journey in life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Reuben, supposed to own as the firstborn, is supposed to be the ruler in the family and is supposed to take the highest point of respect in the family. But somewhere along the line in his life, what belongs to him was given unto two people, Judah and Joseph, shared his portion. And the man began to diminish. He became a liability in life. He was supposed to be the elder son, but he has to be depending on his brothers to survive. He has to live, he has to be at the mercy of his brothers. How come that those who are Christian, who supposed to be the key in the family, still has to go and begin to tell their unbelieving brothers, say, help me out now. Do something in my life now. And when you want to talk about Jesus, he tell you to shut up your mouth there. If your Jesus is anything, he will have given you this one. And most of the time when you want to talk, you can't, because you know that there is so much that you are supposed to have experienced that you have not seen. Beginning from today, everything that has been shutting your mouth, that has not allowed you even to speak as you're supposed to and to the people you ought to, tonight they will be removed in the name of Jesus. How come should a Christian be in the same office when God says you will be the head And the promotion time come, it is unbeliever that is being promoted ahead of you. And so when you want to go to fellowship, you say, I want to say no fellowship. There is nothing like fellowship. We are staying till 7 p.m. in this office. How come that you are a Christian? You need to bid for contracts with unbeliever and they will get it over you. How come that all the blessing that's supposed to come to believers, unbelievers are taking them? There will be a reversal today. By the power of the living God, all your entitlement that you are supposed to be enjoying, but one way or the other, it has never gotten to you. Beginning from tonight, you will begin to enjoy them. I say you will begin to enjoy them. In the mighty name of Jesus. If for any reason they look at you and they say, well, you are supposed to be, you are our elder before, but you are behind us now. The anointing of God to get back your place will come upon your life today. Amen. There is a healing to your life in order to take you to your prime place and to your position in life. In the mighty name of Jesus. The promise of God is that the land belongs to his children. It says specifically to Joshua in chapter 1 in verse 5. He said there will never be any man that will be strong enough to withstand you all the days of your life. You are undefeatable champion. Tonight you are getting back. Yes. You are going back. Yes. You are taking possession. Yes. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Colossians chapter 1 verse 18 was talking about Jesus in reference to what belonged to the firstborn. He said, and he is the head of the body, the church. Who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. That in all things he might have the preeminence. What is it that will give Jesus preeminence in all things? Because he's the firstborn. And because we belong, you know, to that clan of the firstborn, we're supposed to also enjoy preeminence in every area and aspect of our life. That is the reason why tonight God has set a table of healing for our life to break the shackle of shame and reproach out of our life and to bring back into our life the coat of many colors. The man who wore the coat of many colors is the one that others envied. And so there is something to be envied in your life. And that the Lord will stir up tonight. Amen. Beginning from this moment, that which will make men to envy your blessing, the Most High God release upon your life in the name of Jesus. The Most High God release upon your life in the name of Jesus. The Most High God release upon your life in the name of Jesus. Tonight, an end has come to anything and to everything that says you must remain reproached. All you need to do this night is look at where you have missed it. Sincerely and genuinely look in the direction of God. You may have repented whatever before, but if you have missed it at any point in your life, and your chances seems to have been taken away from you, you want to ask the Lord for restoration. Mercy that bring restoration. And I give you the guarantee that that will be your portion in Jesus' name. Tonight is not a night that we need to beg anybody to surrender their life to Jesus. If you want to remain down, remain there. The forces that want to hold you down, sit over you and ground your nose on the dust, they are ready. But God is giving opportunity to you tonight. Take advantage of the opportunity. Let's rise to our feet. It is time for us to pray.